So let's talk a little bit about COVID in China, but it's not the couple dozen cases here in Beijing. Something a bit more interesting that I came across, and we're going to examine both how the media represents things in a very misleading way and how that causes people to overlook the most important parts of a story. So let's take a look at the desktop here. So this all began when I saw an article from CNN that says this. Let me make it a little smaller because my logo. Nearly 500,000 people may have had COVID-19 in Wuhan, study shows. That's almost 10 times the official figure. So we know that something like 60% of people or more just read the headline and skip right past the rest of it. So that means most people who have seen this article believe a couple of things. 500,000 people had COVID in Wuhan, which is further evidence that the virus came from Wuhan, and further evidence that the Chinese government is bad and wrong. That's the first thing that they may believe from this. And the second thing that they may believe is that the Chinese government or the Chinese health officials have been reporting only a tenth of the actual cases of COVID, which again goes back to say how bad and wrong the Chinese government or the health officials are. And that's pretty much all everybody's going to get from this. Now, the minority of people that actually will read it may discover a few extra things, but I doubt that most people reading this are going to notice the most important thing that this article is suggesting, because they don't mention it anywhere in here, and you actually have to think about things and compare this to other articles and start to realize, wow, there's something that you totally missed by not doing any investigative journalism, but just presenting this in the sloppiest, quickest way possible. So, this person whose name apparently is Nectar, you could have been a little bit sweeter if you did a little bit of extra work here. So, let's take a look at what this actually says. There's a study by the Chinese CDC that uses a bunch of people, mostly from Wuhan. Okay, they test a bunch of people, and then they also test from the rest of Hubei and then other places in China. Okay. Now there's 3% here. 4.43% in Wuhan. All right. Blah, 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 blah. 0.44% in the rest of Hubei. Okay. And then 2 out of 12,000, which is 1 out of 6,000, which is like 0.02% or something like that. So that's the rest of China. Okay. So we've got 3 different percents. 4.43 for Wuhan, 0.44 for the rest of Hubei. And like 0.02% for the rest of China. All right. Now, the sampling date is a little bit unclear. It seems to be around April or so, but it's just not very clear, even in the study. So this is the release from the CDC. It's in Chinese, obviously. This is the Google translated version of it. And sure enough, it basically says the same thing that the CNN report says. Okay. And the only thing it really says about the time is this part here where it says, survey time is selected 1 month after my country has contained the first wave of COVID. So I don't know if that's supposed to be late February, March, April. I don't know. Something like that. But it doesn't really matter because I'm going to exaggerate the bad and I'm going to downplay the good. And we're still going to see quite an interesting discovery. So we've got this report from CNN that's basically telling everybody how bad the Chinese government is because they're underreporting everything, and more evidence that COVID clearly started in Wuhan. So let's do a little bit of a deeper dive. So this article goes on to say New York City residents in August were about 27% infected or had been infected. Kind of interesting, 27%. Now, why would Americans be so infected with this virus, such a high percent? You could say it's because Americans like to hug each other, whereas Chinese people generally don't touch each other in loose social settings. Okay, but I mean, Americans don't really do a lot of kissing on the cheek. Sometimes we'll do a kiss on the cheek, you know, for trying to pretend like we're European, but it's not very normal. And then you could say, well, we didn't lock it down, whereas China did. Okay, those are all valid. That's all true. But that's an extreme difference, 27%, right? So it's just very interesting to contrast that. But no, of course, nobody will see this. So as we go on, we start to think about, okay, so that means that China had, if we do the math here, 1 million cases, okay? 1 million cases. Let me pull up the numbers here. Okay, so we're going to downplay the bad, I mean the good, and we're going to upplay the bad. So this is the percents, right? So Wuhan's like 11 million people. 4.43% of that's, you know, 487,000. 0.44% of the rest of Hubei, right? So this is Hubei minus Wuhan, right? So that's another 200,000. 0.02% of the rest of China is this much. Add them together, and let's just clean that up. 1 million. So 1 million cases. Now, this population and this population and this population and the polling, it's somewhere around April, but I think we can probably bring it up to today since there really hasn't been much spreading. Okay, so let's just say that if we increase this by a bit, then China has something like 1 million cases of COVID. Wow, that really sounds extreme, given that if we look here, this is China, right? China has reported about 100,000 cases. All right. So far, everything seems to be exactly what we thought it would be. That's 10 times the official figure. But there's something that I think China really regrets doing now, which is that they weren't reporting the asymptomatic cases. So that means that in the short term, you have less case count, but later you open yourself up to having these types of stories come out where it looks like you're underreporting by a massive amount. So let's explore what I'm talking about here. If we pull up my COVID timeline, I have two of them here. I want to look at the China one. So here's just some quick studies that I found just to make this video. There's many, many more, but if we look at these pink ones here, up to 50% of cases are asymptomatic. 35% of cases are asymptomatic. 80% are asymptomatic. 25%, 81%, right? 17%. I believe that the Diamond, what's it called? The Diamond Princess cruise ship. I think that their asymptomatic was something like 51%. So that's the first piece of information, is that there's a large amount of asymptomatic cases, okay? And the second piece of information is this interesting little tidbit, that certain types of tests have a very hard time detecting asymptomatic cases. So this article from MIT says that these rapid virus tests only find about, they only detect 32% of the asymptomatic cases. Isn't that crazy? So, but let's just ignore that, okay? Because that might be a little bit of a stretch. So forget that. Let's just assume that every asymptomatic person which you test, you will immediately know that they are infected, okay? Well, that means that we need to figure out how many cases has China known existed but not reported them because they were asymptomatic, okay? Cheyenne, Chi-Tech, old friend of mine, how you doing? Next time I come out to LA, maybe in 2 years or so, let's hang out. So if we look at these asymptomatic numbers, right, the problem is we don't really know what's the actual final number. So we have to kind of guess here. So let's just take some numbers here and let's try to see what types of numbers we could be looking at based on the fact that some percent of these cases are going to be asymptomatic, which means that they wouldn't have been reported by China because China wasn't reporting asymptomatic cases. So here we go. I already did a little bit of this. So if it's 20% asymptomatic, then that means that we should expect that from China saying we've confirmed 100,000 symptomatic cases, we should interpret that as meaning that there are 125,000 total cases, okay? Maybe that's, is that based on the... Oops. Yeah. So that number probably looks a little weird, but it's because it's not saying 20% more. It's saying 20% of the total would have been asymptomatic, which means this would be 80% of the total. Okay, so you have to take that, and then you basically are saying divided by 0.8. Okay, so that's what this means. So if it's 20%, then we could expect that what they're saying is 100%, 100,000 cases being confirmed means around 125,000 total cases, including asymptomatic. Now we have at least two studies that say it's 80% or even more. So somewhere in here lies the amount that China is actually saying that that's how many cases that they have based on the Western interpretation of what cases means, or I don't want to say Western, the American interpretation. Okay, so what does that mean? Well, what that means is that this headline that says that's almost 10 times the official figure is misleading, because the official figure doesn't include asymptomatic, but this test does. Okay, and China has been very clear about that. So if we take a look at the further numbers here, let's just say that we average this out, right? Well, that's over 300,000, okay, which we can tone that down, but let's just take a look. So 125 plus 200 plus 500 divided by 3. Sorry, no, that's not the right way to do it. It's 20 to 80, so it's 20 to 80, which is 100, yeah, which is 50. So it's 200,000. So if it's 200,000 cases that they're saying, then that means that this is actually around 5 times the amount, not 10 times. And now I know what you're thinking. Yeah, that's still 5 times more than what they're reporting. And you're absolutely correct. This is not good, right? Good is 100% of the cases are discovered and reported. However, as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, if you focus on that fact, then you're still just left thinking, well, they didn't report, you know, shame on them. And you're completely missing a huge point here, okay? So NY Rail fan says, why they underreport? So the reason that, generally speaking, let's go with all countries, the reason that countries underreport is because they haven't tested all the people. It's almost never because they have tested the people and know the numbers and then lie about those numbers. That's not usually what the situation is. Usually it's because studies like this are more exhaustive and thorough that come much later and they have plenty of time to do them. Whereas when you're in the middle of a pandemic, you don't sit there and go, well, let's thoroughly test each and every person and get really clean and clear with all of our documentation. You're more focused on saving lives. That's generally what happens. In addition to that, the testing is very unreliable when these first start. If you recall, I've mentioned a few times this little tidbit. These beige items are pieces of information that we learned during this whole process. So you can see that back in February is when we started to realize that, like, this woman tested positive after 8 negative test results. So what does that tell you? Well, that means that the day before this happened, she would have been counted as not having COVID-19, when in fact she did have COVID-19. It also means that later studies, which would deal with, you know, that she would be a part of, if you had asked how many cases China had the day before this happened, then you would have underreported her because you would have said that she was negative, whereas later it turned out she was actually positive. And if you hadn't done the 9th COVID test, then you would have probably never found that she had COVID. Until later when you do a more thorough test. So that means that this lady is just one example of why underreporting happens. It's not really a China issue so much as a every country issue. So the testing is very, very spotty, especially earlier on. And, you know, people don't have the motivation to sit there and be obsessed with documentation when they're trying to quash an epidemic. Okay, so then what was I talking about? Man, I really wish that I had recorded that. I was on a roll, people. So that's why we've got some underreporting happening. Now, if we look at the United States, we can see that this is where things get a little bit crazy. As of around December 13th, we're pretty sure that America had between 4 and 6 million COVID-19 cases. Now, that comes from this NPR study. This NPR report says, very boringly says, coronavirus was in U.S. weeks earlier than previously known, study says. Yawn, nothing to see here. But if you actually look at the study, what it says is, what it says is that December 13th through December 16th, 2019, they found a 2% prevalence of COVID-19. 2%, okay? So, given that America is something like 330 million people, that's about 6.5 million COVID cases, December 13th through 16th, 2019, not 2020. Then they expanded it and they found, going through January 17th, 1.2%. Which is about 4 million. So something between 4 and 5 million people, somewhere in there, is what we can expect to see December 13th, 2019, because it takes quite some time to get infected and to get these antibodies and everything. So it was certainly earlier than this. However, we will just downplay the good and upplay the bad against China, right? Because that's what everybody likes to do. So let's just make it, no, they didn't have 5 million earlier than this. They had 5 million at this point. Okay, fine. But this is really, really changing the significance of this article, don't you think? Because this article says there's almost 5 times, not 10 times, but 5 times the official figure. But wait a second. I mean, that means nothing, because every country is going to do that. Forget about that. The important question you should be asking CNN is, how is it possible that the United States of America had 5 million cases December 13th, and 4 months later, China only had 1/5 of that? How could it have come from China if America had 5 times as many cases 4 months earlier? In fact, it had 5 million cases 2 weeks before we even had one confirmed case in China. Now, again, clearly that means that there was cases before the 26th. We know that for sure. In fact, the earliest one we know of in China is the 1st of December. But in America, there was definitely cases earlier than the 1st of December if they had 5 million cases 12 days later. So that kind of brings us to, isn't it interesting that you can still say that COVID-19 came from China when there was 5 million cases 2 weeks before we heard about the first case in China? I mean, now, it doesn't mean that the virus didn't come from China, and it doesn't mean that it came from America, but it just means it's now much less likely that it came from China. Because even if it came from one of these earlier places, for example, we know that COVID-19 was in Italy September 2019, confirmed. We know that. So since we know that, it is possible that it came from Italy, but it's also possible it came from many other places. We don't know where it came from, but I do think that it's pretty interesting that 5 million cases in the U.S., less than 2 months from the Wuhan military games, and Wuhan was the place most affected by far in China. So I know that a lot of this can get conspiratorial, and I do want to just be CIA, can you be more subtle? I do want to be very clear and careful to talk about these things. I made a video that essentially debunked the theory that the virus was created at Fort Detrick and released on purpose or accidentally to Wuhan. And the reason that I don't believe that conspiracy theory is that I don't have sufficient evidence to believe that conspiracy theory. It's the same reason I don't believe in Bigfoot or other things like that. But as I mentioned in that video, there is actually a lot of circumstantial evidence for that. It doesn't mean that it's true. It just means there's some very interesting things that need to be looked at. And this, by the way, is further evidence of that. Because, again, how is it possible, without yourself depending on a new conspiracy theory, how is it possible that the U.S. had 5 million cases and China didn't even have 1 million cases? How is that possible? And furthermore, and I mentioned this in another video, I want to be super clear. Every single conspiracy theory you've ever heard about bat doctors in November of 2019, and parking lots with cars moving around that means that the Wuhan laboratory has done this or that, and all of this crazy right-wing conspiracy theory stuff, all of that is totally, thoroughly debunked, in case that's not clear, because nothing that happened in November has anything to do with the virus being discovered in September in Italy. Okay? None of it. So, just to be clear, if you hear anybody still talking about those things, then they're just pumping out this flat earth theory type of crap. Currently, it could be that the virus came from China. However, this report that doesn't at all mention this in any way, this report is actually highlighting the fact that it's much less likely now that it came from China than it ever has been before. So, that's what I wanted to say about COVID in China. We also have some more cases coming in Beijing. People are locking down quite a bit. We're all a little bit nervous about New Year's Eve and all that kind of stuff. But this is what I actually wanted to tell you. So let's go back again, one last time, to the original article. Nearly 500,000 people may have had COVID-19 in Wuhan, study shows. That's almost 10 times the official figure. Huh? The focus that you have is like, see, it like probably came from Wuhan and they're underreporting. When in fact, the real reality of what this is highlighting is, wow, that means that there's almost no chance now that it actually came from Wuhan. Isn't that interesting? Wow.